రీజన్ చెప్పేది ఇంక్రీజ్ ఆన్ టైర్స్ అండ్ అదర్ ఇండీస్. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు థ్యాంక్స్ మిస్టర్ టి రాధాకృష్ణ గివ్ మీ అన్ ఆపర్చునిటీ టు బి అమంగ్ యూ అండ్ టు షేర్స్ మై ఐడియాస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో లిసన్ టు యువర్స్. వి ఆల్ ఆర్ గ్రోయింగ్ టుగెదర్ బై షేరింగ్ ఐడియాస్ అండ్ లర్నింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఈచ్ అదర్. సీ, ఐ ఎమ్ వివేక్ జైస్వాల్. Works as a general manager, sales and marketing in BSNL. I belong to Indian Telecom Service and alumnus of IIM Lucknow. The topic which I am going to cover is the role of mobile and digital technologies in improving financial inclusion and customer engagement in NBFC. I deliberately kept my topic very focused to what is value addition to NBFC, though there is a very larger topic we can discuss. As the time was given about 10 minutes to me, so I will try to cover up in this one. So about 5 minutes talk and around 4 to 5 minutes of a video which I will show you. So this all we know about it, NBFC, you people belong to the NBFC industry, so you know that you are playing very critical role not only for generating business, for yourself, for your employees, but you are serving community as a whole. Which was earlier in the form of when these NBFCs were not prominent, it was in terms of sahukars who were just exploiting particularly poor people. So what issues which are being faced by NBFC which we can solve with the help of mobile technology or digital technology? I have taken only two issues. One is how we can increase our reach that we call financial inclusion. Or how we can serve our customer in a better way. These two things I am going to cover. So issues which I am going to cover is the operational cost, which is actually high. And if you reduce operational cost, it means your margin, your profit is going to increase. So that we will try to cover. Particularly when we have to serve a remote or rural location, customers on that side, then cost is high. And as you know, in all sectors, there is a cutthroat competition. Of course, in NBFC, may not be an under sector. So here also competition is very high among people. If we keep on focusing on the same set of customers which are in urban area, maybe it is difficult for us to sustain our business or sustain the growth which everyone of us is desiring to get into our business. So cashless method, can we do it? Who is not having a bank account? That is what we are going to cover. Or even if a person is having a bank account, but he is living in a rural area where bank is about 10 km away from his place. So why to take, when he has to take his own disbursement, or he has to repay, why he has to travel 10 km? Why he has to go for about, in banking hours only, which is 10 to 4 normally? So we will see that with the help of new technologies, we will try to gap this, we will fill gap, this gap and will be profitable for NBFC. And what about when the customer is not having, when we are talking about digital technology, the things which comes into our mind is smartphone. See, we know smartphone is there. It is going to increase in coming days. But still I will show in one of PPT, there is a huge number of mobile customers who are still with feature phone. Some of them are your potential customers. So we will see how we can reach to them. So basically we are, whatever money disbursement NBFCs are doing, they are doing through banks. And so one has to have a bank account. So as I said, if your customer who want to take credit from you or loan from you, but he is not having any bank account, or it is not easily accessible, so what to do? What we can do, that we can use mobile technology. As you all know, that mobile is, other than other, mobile is the, I think, only item which is almost prevalent across India, everywhere. Banks, maybe some bank accounts may be there, but they are not matching mobile numbers. So, all telecom service providers have recently started mobile wallet services or payment bank services, but still this service is not being used by NBFC. It is still being used by, when we talk about payment services or mobile wallet, We are using it for small transactions. We are using it for doing transaction in some shop, or sending money from one wallet to other wallet, or paying utility bills. Almost 6 months or 8 months are there when this service is started, and it is going to increase as mobile all telecom operators are finding this value addition, because they already had what is required to give the services. They have technology, they have invested in equipment, they have used retail network. Now with the some software development, some addition of it, value addition, we, even the bank, now the, this mobile phone is working as an extension of bank account. NBFC, as per my understanding, they are not using this method, but this is a proven method, it is already in place. It can be customized for NBFC also. How? We will see. And as you know, that it is a very secure and very transparent method. With some statistics, as mobile customers, as on 30 September, data released by TRAI, is around 1183 million. In rural, 498. Approximately 500 million customers are in rural. Broadband customer is 306.85. So when we say this broadband customer, it means these are the smartphone users. But you see, this feature phone customer, they are still 876 million. So these actually represent a huge customer base which you can claim through your services. See, technology will only provide a method to reach to your customer. Product and services you have to decide, you are already in that job. Some estimate I have taken on website that around 400 million unique bank accounts are still present. It is, this data belongs to 2016. So if NBFC can meet the credit need of these huge customers who are my feature phone customer, and it doesn't mean they are not having credit needs. And you can meet it profitably. See, you can of course give anyone, but it should be profitable to you also. So you will not only improve financial inclusion, but you will also ensure business, this steps will also ensure business growth for your company, which is desirable. I will only, as I told you, this is not only about the BSNL product. You can go and you can check up with all DSPs are providing some sort of product. So you please take it as a concept which I am showing to you. Not only for the competition of the product. So we have tie up with the SBI. State Bank of India and BSNL, they have tie up and they designed a wallet which is MobiCash, and actually it is designed for rural population. So apart from other features, we all use Paytm. It's one of the most prevalent, most used app by anyone. Almost all of us are might be using it or might have seen it sometime. But Paytm is a P2P service. MobiCash is a wallet, and I will focus on only one particular aspect of MobiCash, which is called cash in and cash out. Because this is where application or the synergy with NBFC comes in. What we want to say, when you have to give money to your customer who may be say in remote village of Tumkur, so instead of sending your person or telling your customer to come to bank, you can use this service. MobiCash is present there, because this is operated through customer service point of BSNL, which is actually its retail network. It is not only customer service center. It could be any pawn shop wala or kirana shop which could be there. Generally they operate from 8 to 8 or 8 to 10 in rural locations also. So with this technology, they can deposit money which is actually meant for you if it is case of repayment, or they can take out money which is you are sending to that person through this network. Of course, some charges are available, applicable, it's a very minimal, maybe around 10 or 12 rupees per pound. That is actually used for feeding, to bank, or some to operator, or some to retail thing. So this is what we are using, it is a retail thing, and at the same time, this can be customized for NBFC, if and they can tie up with any TSP, because this is a product which everyone is using. So we will just see if this is suitable to you and you can use it. Just for I want to show you one video which will be, it is actually in Hindi. It says Makes a customer in Haryana, a village, and then see that how they transact. And just this is a general video, you just see about how it can be applied to NBFC.
सुनो सुनो टेक्नोलॉजी का कमाल सुनो और देखो आपकी जिंदगी में कैसे आएगा आप सुकून। मोबाइल तो मोबाइल, अब मोबाइल पे बैंक का भी इस्तेमाल देखो। स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया BSNL के संग पेश करते हैं मोबी कैश, आपके मोबाइल द्वारा बैंकिंग करने का एक सरल तरीका। ये देखो दामिनी दीदी, गांव बुद्धनपुर हरियाणा में रहती है, 8वीं कक्षा तक पढ़ी है। इनके घर के आसपास कोई बैंक या ATM नहीं है। इनके पति का तो बैंक में खाता है, लेकिन दामिनी ने मोबी कैश चुना। अपने नजदीकी BSNL कस्टमर सर्विस पॉइंट पहुंच गई, विकी गोयल साहब से मिली, उनकी मदद से कुछ सीखा और अब स्टेट बैंक मोबी कैश SMS से पैसे यहां से वहां, वहां से यहां एक चुटकी में भेजती है। जी हां दोस्तों, बैंक अकाउंट हो या ना हो, बैंक और ATM दूर हो या टाइम कम हो, शॉपिंग के लिए ट्रांसफर करो, मोबाइल टॉप अप करो, बिल पेमेंट वॉलेट से वॉलेट में भेजो या वॉलेट से बैंक अकाउंट में जमा करो।
पर मेरा मोबाइल तो स्मार्ट नहीं है।
पर मोबी कैश तो स्मार्ट है, जो हर मोबाइल पर काम करता है। इस वॉलेट के लिए स्मार्टफोन जरूरी नहीं है। वॉलेट यानी के बटुआ, मान की स्टेट बैंक मोबी कैश आपके मोबाइल में पैसे रखने का एक बटुआ है, जो स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया और BSNL आपकी सहूलियत के लिए लेकर आया है। अब देखते हैं दामिनी ने क्या किया। उन्होंने ₹500 CSP को दिया जमा करने के लिए। CSP साहब ने अपने मोबी कैश रिटेलर मोबाइल ऐप में कैश इन सिलेक्ट किया और टैप किया, दामिनी का मोबाइल नंबर डाला, जमा करने की रकम डाली और भेज डाला। और देखा आपने, चुटकी में दामिनी को मैसेज मिला कि रुपए उनकी मोबाइल वॉलेट के खाते में आ चुका है। देखो खुश हुई ना दामिनी, बिल्कुल सुरक्षित है ये मोबी कैश। अब दामिनी दीदी पहुंच गई सब्जी वाले के पास और आलू टमाटर गोभी सब खरीद डाला और रुपया बढ़ाया। आपके पास मोबी कैश नहीं? दामिनी मुस्कुराई, मोबाइल निकाला और SMS भेजा। वो देखिए, वो मुस्कुराए अपने मोबी कैश में रुपया पाने पर। दामिनी ने थैला उठाया और निकल चली। इसी तरह दामिनी ने पास के किराने की दुकान से नमक लिया, नारियल का तेल लिया, लेकिन जनाब रुपया नहीं दिया, मोबी कैश से रुपया भेजा मोबाइल पे। अरे दामिनी तो चल पड़ी, आज तो रामलाल को सभी ने मोबी कैश से ही पेमेंट किया है। उन्होंने SMS भेजा ये जानने के लिए कि आज मोबी कैश में कितने रुपए इकट्ठे हुए हैं। अरे वाह जी वाह, पूरे 1140 रुपए। उसके बाद शहर में पढ़ रही बेटी को रुपया भेजने के लिए SMS भेजा, साथ ही अपने फोन का बिल भी जमा किया, बस टाइप किया और मोबी कैश में बचे हुए रुपयों को भेज दिया अपने खाते में बड़े आसानी से। देखा है ना कमाल की बात। अब देखिए दामिनी ने अगले दिन मोबी कैश से कैश कैसे निकाला। वो पहुंच गई अपने CSP दोस्त विकी गोयल जी के पास, एक SMS भेजा, उनको एक OTP यानी कि वन टाइम पासवर्ड मिला। यह आपकी सुरक्षा के लिए है, ताकि कोई और आपके पैसे को हाथ तक नहीं लगा सके। दामिनी ने OTP CSP दोस्त को बताया, दोस्त ने कैश आउट सिलेक्ट किया, अपनी मोबी कैश रिटेलर ऐप में दामिनी का मोबाइल नंबर, रकम, OTP नंबर और खुद का रिटेलर पिन एंटर किया, भेजा। दोनों को नोटिफिकेशन मिला और दामिनी खुश हो गई। तो एक है दामिनी जिसके पास बैंक खाता नहीं और एक रामलाल जिसके पास बैंक खाता है, दोनों मोबाइल द्वारा बैंकिंग करते हैं, मोबी कैश का SMS यानी मैसेज से या ऐप द्वारा। आप SMS या ऐप का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं एक मोबी कैश वॉलेट से दूसरे मोबी कैश वॉलेट में पैसे भेजने के लिए, और तो और मोबी कैश से किसी भी बैंक के खाते में रुपया भेजे तुरंत बड़ी आसानी से IFSC कोड तथा अकाउंट नंबर द्वारा या फिर MMID कोड तथा मोबाइल नंबर द्वारा। BSNL उपभोक्ता मोबी कैश का इस्तेमाल USSD पर भी कर सकते हैं, जिसके लिए उन्हें डायल करना है #511#। दोस्तों, आप मोबाइल द्वारा आसानी से बैंकिंग कर सकते हो, बिल पेमेंट, मनी ट्रांसफर, मोबाइल रिचार्ज और जल्द ही आप बिजली, पानी और दूसरे बिल भी मोबीकैश से भर पाएंगे। स्टेट बैंक मोबीकैश इस्तेमाल करने के लिए शुरुआत कैसे की जाए? अरे भाई, हजारों BSNL के CSP दोस्त हाजिर हैं आपके लिए पूरे देश भर में। रजिस्ट्रेशन के लिए बस आपका नाम, मोबाइल नंबर, जन्म तिथि और अपना। जो कैश निकालने की सुविधा नहीं चाहते हैं उनके लिए प्रक्रिया यहाँ कंप्लीट होती है, और जो कैश चाहते हैं उन्हें एक आसान सी KYC प्रक्रिया पूरी करनी होगी। KYC प्रूफ जैसे कि आधार कार्ड, वोटर ID वगैरह जमा करें BSNL दोस्त के पास, वो SBI की ब्रांच में भेज देगा और आपको सिर्फ जाना है ओरिजिनल पेपर्स दिखाने के लिए, और फिर शुरू हो जाता है आपका सफर स्टेट बैंक मोबी कैश के संग।
So this was a small video about our service. Now we'll take another 2-3 minutes. Is permitted? Okay. So next point which I want to cover is customer engagement. How we can use digital services or mobile technology to improve our customer engagement? So as I could draw that NBFCs are already engaging customers through their branch network, network agents, employees or through social media. Word of mouth publicity still plays a very important role for the customer beliefs on NBFC, and customer will usually come back to the same lender if he is satisfied with your service. Social media is one of the most favorite media by NBFC, in fact by any other service provider, because it's virtually free. All other media, whether it's a print media or television media, it comes with a huge cost. So what NBFCs are doing, they are promoting, sharing their relevant information, and they can use this media. They are already doing it, but for social media you have to have a smartphone. Without this, how you will use it? So I will discuss both aspects, the person who are having a smartphone and person who are not having a smartphone, how we can use them. First I take with the feature phone. Feature phone is a normal phone which we had, you know, they are Nokia kind of phone, where no smart facility there, only for voice call, SMS and USSD. So SMS marketing is still prevalent. It can be done in local language to suit your customer, targeted customer. USSD, which is an unstructured supplementary service data, that can be used as all of that can be used for real-time transmission of information. We all know that SMS is a store and forward kind of system. If I send you an SMS, it can be delivered instantaneously or it can be delivered after a time. But there is no method of sending it. There is no guarantee that it will be delivered in same immediately. While USSD, UK, the message will be delivered on real time, and this particular channel, it uses GSM network, it doesn't require data connection, and with a simple configuration, most of us might have used this channel, we can add number of value-added services via USSD, in which you can give some information to customer, ask customer to send some information which could be in alphanumeric code like a star, some number 5 and then hash, and send it back to this. So in that way you can pass information, you can take feedback also. So this is SMS marketing, and USSD is still present. We should use it in local language as far as possible, because our targeted customer are generally belongs to a society where they may not be knowing English. Now with the smartphones, as you know that we have to focus on Facebook, Twitter and YouTube. YouTube particularly makes a strong impact on younger generation. Even the younger generation doesn't mean that he is going to be a big shot school or college. The person who is coming at our home as a maid or these people, they are also using videos. They are also using YouTube. And thanks to the rates are coming down in India, data rates, these are going to increase. This trend will continue. So you can make attractive video about your company, your product, and it's always preferable to have a dedicated team. If size doesn't permit for NBFC, you can outsource it. It's a cheaper option for outsourcing instead of in-house dedicated social media management team. We should encourage use of social media by our targeted customer by using some contest. Most of companies like BSNL also keep on giving some contest, and it brings back the enthusiastic customers to continuously on their page so that they can see their product. It saves the operational cost, and to promote this mode, we have to give some promotional cost which you can decide design as per your marketing strategy of your company. One more important thing, we should try, as a NBFC is in a business where groups are important and word of mouth publicity is important, we should promote it to have a community concept or platform, online platform, where you allow user to discuss about your product. Let them criticize it. It's okay, acceptable. Anyway, they are criticizing on your back. You allow them, you take that feedback to improve your product in the future. Because the other feedback channel which you are getting through your agent or your employee may be a biased one, may not be correct one. Of course, you can go for co-creation of future innovative product by engaging your customers. And while you engage them, make sure they will not go away. They will always remain with you. The more and more you engage, they will remain with you. Some more uses for reducing operational cost. One of my friend is in, he has set up and we have a company in some 6 months back. Still your operational cost which, sending your credit manager to prospective customer is going there, discussing. You cannot send a, unskilled person there for this job. You have to keep a credit manager who is sufficiently skilled and you have to pay a good salary to him. Can we use video call? Very simple method. You know, video call is cheaper. Everywhere it is available. So you can directly, as an MD or a startup of company, can directly talk to that person. Similarly, address verification, another issue, because it's very important. You can simply send an unskilled person, take a snapshot with a Google GPS camera. It will show you the lifelong of that particular area, which you can check it further, if it is correct. So this is all about small things which I want to put before you, that how we can use digital and mobile technology for reducing our operational cost and customer engagement. For further connection, you are welcome to connect me on GMSM KTK at BSNL.com.